Hello everyone, myself Tushar Kurunkar. Today I am going to speak on the topic of embedded systems and RF hacking. First of all, I would like to thank you to Hacktify team for giving me this opportunity to discuss with you guys on the topic of embedded systems and RF hacking. So without any further delay, let's start the presentation. Let's see the contents of the presentation. We will go through the introduction of embedded devices, then the methodology and the equipment required to do this process and the impact. Dive into the introduction of RF hacking and then the phases of RF attack and the impact of RF attack hacking. Introduction to embedded devices. Embedded device systems are said to be a combination of hardware and software. That is an electronic system that has a computer software which is embedded in a computer hardware. This hardware platform is generally a microcontroller. Or C++ language. However, embedded system is destined to do a single particular task. For example, pacemaker. This device keeps monitoring heartbeat, so when heart pump goes slow, it takes counteracting action and make heartbeat come back to a normal condition. Some other examples of embedded systems are microwave oven, washing machine, printers, telephones, etc. Let's see the methodology. Now we all know to exploit any system or to find vulnerabilities of the target, we should have our approach or methodology against the target. Now methodology plays a very important role in cybersecurity. The methodology for embedded systems hacking is to look for its three best interfaces, which he or she will find in most of the embedded systems. The three best interfaces are UART, JTAG and SPI. UART is a computer hardware device for asynchronous serial communication in which the data format and transmission speed are configurable. JTAG is an electronics industry association formed in 1985 for developing a method of verifying designs and testing printed circuit boards after manufacture. SPI is a synchronous serial communication interface specifically used for short distance communication and primarily used in embedded systems. Let's see the equipment required to do this process. Some PCB does not label the ports, so we have to identify them by using tools. Most commonly used tools are multimeter, UART adapter, logical analyzers, power supply, JTAG reader, bus parade. Logical analyzers are used because they are protocol aware and they help us to find out the pinouts for specifically debugging the ports. JTAG reader and bus parade are used because they are identifier of UART, JTAG and SPI interfaces. They are not complete without any framework or computer. Let's see the impact of these interfaces. UART can give us a console of a device that is shared here. It also helps us to monitor and it can look for offset, crashes, etc. All the secret credentials or all the binaries like stuff are stored into these interfaces. Error messages or crash logs are usually extremely high, where we can trigger an overflow of a service and try to explore everything from the device. That is a DDoS attack. It also helps us to look what is actually running on the device. And JTAG interface can give us the authority to read and write to on a memory just like a super user of a computer where we can do anything. So further we can also set the breakpoints and we can also give the patch instructions or data into memory. We can also extract the firmware from this interface. We can also bypass the protection, password, checks and checksums, etc. An attack own the device by its firmware and source code by reverse engineering, and it's easily available on the vendor's website with its source code too. So attacker first extracts the firmware from vendor website with the help of WinWar, or else he can extract the firmware through a interface that is JTAG. Then with the help of firmworker, all kind of shadow files, hash files, password, PS key files, IP address versions, emails and lot of stuff can be extracted from these interfaces. It is super useful and also customizable. For example, we can take PCB of router where we will apply all the scenario which we have just discussed before. And thus, in this way, we can own the device. Let's see the introduction of RF hacking. Radio frequency hacking is said to be the most dangerous attack as it can expose some very private communications or by overpowering the legitimate signal. Videos to public. So basically radio frequency devices are used in our daily life cycle, which can be vulnerable and might take any sensitive data. These radio frequencies has their own wave spectrum where various devices worked on some frequency band. For example, FM radio operates on 100 MHz, GPS and cell phone operates on 1 GHz. Apart from this, there are cars connected to mobile phones and GSM and they operate on 2.4 GHz. So there is, all these can be easily vulnerable with low cost tools such as GNA radio, RTL, SDR, hack RF and etc. Let's see the phases of RF attack. So we all are familiar with OSM model and RF attack happens on the physical layer of the OSM model. The four phases of the RF attack are information gathering, frequency, modulation, and then transmission. In information gathering, we can gather information of a device through its FCC ID, which is labeled on the device. Through this, we can get all the information about the device. Then we have to see the frequency. It is very important to understand the device which we are testing works on which frequency band so that we can use GQRX, which is spectrum analyzer, to analyze those kind of frequencies to plot FFT and waterfall through which we can get frequency band of a device. Next comes the modulation. It is like a hiding a code inside a carrier wave. It represents a digital data as variations in that carrier wave. Then comes the transmission. Now from all the study we know the frequency of a device and then modulation of a device. Now we have to transmit this signal through tools like GNA radio and etc. To transmit the signal we need to know frequency, modulation, bitrate, sync word and preamble. Bitrate, it is a transmitting rate where per second how many samples are transmitted. In simple words, it is a sample per second. Sync word and preamble are the backup signals. Every time this will be same for every IoT and RF devices. So in this way we can own any device which works on RF signals. I would like to say about the researchers in Manhattan who work on embedded systems. They recently developed an exploit which allows to effectively bug embedded devices without physical touching them and exposing sensitive data. They work on everything from printers, monitors to drones, all kinds of machines that we rely on every day. They have created a malware which is called as Fontana, which exploits radio frequencies which was implemented on telephones through software where they can listen the communications without actually touching them. This attack is really powerful as it can leak most secret details such as military secrets or any confidential meetings. By this, it can lead us into cyber war. So that's the reason embedded systems and RF hacking should be secured. And there is a tremendous need to secure these RF signals and embedded devices to avoid wireless attacks and to avoid any chaos. That's all from my side.